Was it for Sarah Sutton? I'm not sure. So we could spread out.
No, Sarah has not put on any weight, so.
Is it to, we could be in a bus?
I could lie down.
Yeah. So, tell me about your mother.
Yeah. Okay. Yes.
Yes. I wanted to obviously talk about your time with Peter and with Tom.
If you must.
And actually, I was thinking about this straight off the bat, was I could only think of one other actress who had played a companion opposite three consecutive doctors.
Three consecutive doctors?
Yeah. Because you were with Tom and you were Peter, and you did the Sontoran thing with Colin Baker.
Yeah, but I also did the Five Doctors special.
Yeah.
With Pert.
Yeah.
And with
Patrick Troughton.
Patrick Troughton. I loved that.
But you see, William Hartnell wasn't, it was Richard Herndon.
It was Richard Herndon, that's what I was trying
to say.
Tom wasn't in that, but I have worked with all of the Doctors, except the ones in the new series, and William Hartnell, who was...
We need to rectify that, right?
Yeah.
So I have worked with Patrick, John, Tom, Peter Davison. Into Every Life, A Little Rain Must Fall. And I did Sylvester's screen test, because John Nathan Turner got me back to do Sylvester's screen test. So almost all the people in the classic Doctor Who series I work with, yeah.
So they owe all their success.
I feel so, yeah. Yeah, I feel that's fair.
I think that's right.
Yeah.
So how was it bridging, because you were brought in...
Ask me who my favourite Doctor was. Because it wasn't Peter Davison.
Who was your favourite Doctor?
Patrick Troughton, because he was a sweetie.
I wanted to take you back to the very beginning, really.
Yeah.
And talk about your introduction to the show.
Right.
And how you bridged that regeneration between 4 and 5. You were brought in that story.
Well, actually, it was really funny, because, I mean, I'd done a really tiny thing in A House of Horror, but that was really my first television.
Opposite Angela Bruce.
Yeah.
Who went on to play Brigadier Van Beren.
Yeah. So, it was really weird. And they weren't, in those days, I don't know what they're like now, but they weren't in those days very supportive or very helpful. And there was a scene where we had to watch Tom fall from a gantry. And, you know, I knew how fast he'd fallen, so I'm going like that, because that's what had happened. But, of course, somebody should have given us an eye line. So if you look at it, we're all looking at different rates of fall. And nobody had thought to say, because you were so, you know,
Who looked the fastest? Who went?
Me. Because nobody had given us an eye line, so there should have been the production manager, who should have known better, was setting the concert for the studio, and she should have given us an eye line to follow, you know, which would have been just a finger going down my back. And I mean, a few weeks later, I would have known that. But it was my first time in a television studio. And it comes up every so often. It came up in a sort of blooper show recently. I just thought, here it is 30 years later, you know.
Well, that's just cruel, isn't it?
It is cruel, yeah.